Welcome to Python with Andrew, where we look at some simple ideas with Python, short, sharp videos, and a chance for you to then practice on the basics as we build and grow our Python skills. We're talking about functions at the moment, and another one of the features of functions, we've just started with, you can have an argument, a parameter, you can send information into functions. Let's have a look a bit deeper and see what we can do within a function and take it a little bit further. Okay, so let's have a little bit more detail on functions. I'm going to jump over to my Visual Studio Code. Now, in this scenario, what I want to do is I want to take a parameter in, and it's going to be a list this time, not just a simple variable, a list. And I'm going to introduce a number of people that are in that list. So for example, I might define my function, introduction. And in this case, it's going to take names. Well, I'll call it list of name, list of names, so that we know that it's a list. Okay. So when I call this, I'm going to call it with Andrew, John, and Peter, and it's going to say hello. Now, in the last one, we just had a print statement, very basic statement. This time, I'm going to actually loop through the list of names. And so I'm going to use a variable to do that. I'm going to do n names. All right. So a simple loop. And then I'm going to print hello n. All right. And that should go through, list of names, okay? So that should go through our list of names and print out each person's name one at a time. So far it looks okay. And if I go down here and I call it introduction, I'm gonna call it with a list, Andrew, let me spell my name correctly. John and Jill, just to pick three names. And hopefully if I save that and run that, it should go, hello, John, hello, Andrew, hello, John, hello, Jill, exactly as we'd expect. But if we look a little bit deeper, a bit more is happening because what I've done is I've created a function and it has one parameter, list of names. We've done that already. That's nice and easy. But I've also created a variable in there, n. I could have called it name, I could have called it n, I could have called it x. It's just a variable. And I'm going to use that to cycle through the list. What's really important here is to note that both the variable n and the one above it, they only exist in this function. They don't exist in our code at all. They only exist in this function. So for example, if I tried down here, to print n, right, I should get an error because it should say n's not defined. In fact, I do, n is not defined. And even if I try to print the n, not n, but list of names, I should get an error again. List of names is not defined. And that's because the variables that I use in my function, either as a parameter or within the function, they only exist while that function's being used. They don't exist in all of your code, only within that function. And that's very important because, and that's a very good feature because we can think of it as being a localized definition. We don't have to worry about it. So I can use n in this function and I could define another function that uses n and another function that uses n, and they're all, if you like, a different copy of that n. They're not exactly the same. And that's nice and good because it means I can focus in on this function and I don't have to worry about anyone else's variable names or getting the wrong variable name. I'm only working within the function. Of course, the flip side means that I cannot access this list of names from that function. I would because it does not exist outside that function. I think that's a very good feature. We'll see how we can access variables outside the function, but I don't think it's a particularly good idea. I prefer to say, if we need variables in the function, we either pass them in as parameters or we create them as we go along, right? So let's delete that one there. During this, I could just say I equals zero and then print I. Okay, that exists in my code. Right. I is going to be printed in that function, exists in that function, but it does not exist outside the function. And that's a key concept. It's, if you like, local variables. So any of the variables in your function that you define within a function or are parameters in that function, they are local and they only exist inside the function. And before we finish, one other quick note is if here I had list, well, I'm going to call it name list, just to make it a little bit different. All right, if that's name list equals, and then I call this name list. Okay. Let's be very clear. This and line 12, this variable here exists throughout the Python code, if you like. And I've called it Andrew, John, and Jill. And then I'm using it as an argument into the function. Okay, so this one, if you like, is not a local variable, nothing to do with this function here. It's purely to do with outside. Okay, so that's more like a global variable as opposed to a local variable. Important concepts, and we'll see that come through. And I must say, if people make mistakes using functions, it's usually because they get that confused. They either try and access in this function something outside the function, which is not particularly good, or outside here, they're trying to access something inside the function. So be careful every time you define a function. Think of it as, I've only got the variables inside that function and outside the function different. So that's it. A little bit more detail on functions. Practice that. Make sure that you can see where, if you like, the variables exist and don't exist. And create your own functions to test that out. And until next time, have a great day.